Thank you for your kind introduction. Can you see my presentation?
Yes.
Okay, I can start. Today, I'd like to present you a literature review on tools that are needed to implement lean production in an Industry 4.0 environment. Here the outline of my presentation. I will start with the background and goals, and I will explain you the literature review process that I use for conducting my research. I will show you results that are made of two parts, a descriptive and content analysis, and finally conclusions and future developments. Industry 4.0 is the fourth industrial revolution, and as we know, it describes the vision of a smart production system that meets market requirements using new technologies. Such technologies are the so-called nine pillars that we can see in the picture here, that are the augmented reality, system integration, cloud computing, big data, IoT, Internet of Things, 3D printing, cybersecurity, autonomous robots, and simulation. The current demand for the mass production of highly customized products is leading to complex products and an increasing demand for production flexibility. Nowadays, lean production and high automation are currently two strategies for addressing these issues. For this reason, the aims of our work is to understand, through a comprehensive literature review, which Industry 4.0 enabling technologies are currently implemented in lean production by companies, and the reason for which technologies are implemented, and advantages derived from their use. I would like to spend some words for explaining the methodology that we followed. That is a conventional but comprehensive literature review that is made of five main steps. The first step consists in using search string for exploring databases. Search strings are keywords. I place here some example: Industry 4.0, Lean Production, Engineering, Manufacturing. For exploring databases such as Web of Science, Scopus, the main the reference database, but also Tripoli, for example, Tripoli database. And these keywords have been combined each other through Boolean operators such as AND, OR. The second step is the consists in locating and selecting articles, and we included papers only derived from present in peer-reviewed journals, written obviously in English. And we cover a search period from 2016 to 2021, last 5 years. In the third step, we evaluated articles. This step is made by three subsequent phases. First phases, in the first phase, the abstract of each paper was read independently by all the authors. And each author expressed a rank, a judgment in reference to the content of the article, if they match or not the scope of our review. The rank could be adequate, inadequate, or partially adequate. Papers that have been considered as inadequate by at least two authors were directly excluded from the subsequent phases and steps. On the contrary, articles that passed the first selection have been read entirely. In the step four, there was the assessment of findings that consists in the compilation and elaboration of a database, an electronic database in a Microsoft Excel environment, according to the year, title, abstract, emerging aspect, and clusters. Finally, in the fifth step, there is the reporting of findings through a synthesis phase, where emerged aspects and results are extracted from database and discussed. Here it's possible to see the paper selection process. The five step in the first column, the name of the step that I reported before, and the filtering operation of article. We started with a sample of 251 papers, and the final cluster of paper counts 36 papers. Again, the selected 36 articles were analyzed through different criteria and divided into different clusters that could be strategy, management, and technical implementation. Research design, if it's quantitative or more qualitative, and the research method that the authors followed, survey, case study, review, and so on. In relation to the descriptive analysis, I would like to show you some statistical data about paper that we found. On the left side, we can see the temporal distribution of articles, and as is possible to see, there is an increasing trend of number of publications during last 3-4 years. Actually, also 2021, we stopped the search process on March. And then I expect that the number is comparable with 2020. We have only seven, but I think at least the same number of 2020, but also more is possible to forecast. In the right side, there is the number of research papers collected according to the country of the first author. Italy is the country with the most of the paper, 9, followed by Brazil and India and Morocco. Here, the number, similarly, the number of articles according to the geographic area, the continent of the first author of the paper. Europe is the first one with 16 papers, followed by Asia and South America. Finally, for concluding the descriptive analysis, I would like to show you the number of articles collected according to the journal. The journal with most of the paper is the Journal of Production Research with 8 papers, followed by Production Planning and Control and Journal of Manufacturing Technology Management. Lean production, that as we know refers to a wide-ranging set process that improves mass production techniques for reducing cost, quality, time to produce, and better react to market demand, we found as an emerged aspect that the application of Industry 4.0 technology and lean production method is generally called by several authors lean automation. Lean automation combines benefits from both domains. And the emergence of specific Industry 4.0 technology during last years, Internet of Things, cyber physical system, but also cloud computing, has recently widened the application range of lean automation, and it's possible to integrate automation technology into lean production. Therefore, lean automation it can be considered as a cost-efficient and effective way to improve production system flexibility in the context of Industry 4.0. As a result of the content analysis, we made a table in which it's possible to see in the first column the reference in Industry 4.0 tool that has been used by papers that we collected in literature, how such tools have been implemented, and the results that have been obtained, for example, in case studies. This is a summarizing table, and it doesn't follow specifically only one paper. It's the results of a collection of all the papers, collection results of all the paper. For example, cyber-physical system and augmented reality, through the integration of Industry 4.0 technology, it's possible to obtain, for example, the toolware prediction and cyber-physical system-human interaction. As a result, it's possible to implement processes that are considered smart enough to identify an undesired abnormal condition and stop the production for not having a defective product or information. Another tool is the augmented reality that is able to enable the smart, the so-called smart operator or operator 4.0, that is equipped with a wearable computing system that, for example, receive failure and display in real time information to the operator. Cyber-physical system and Internet of Things that enable cyber-physical systems also enable, for example, a smart machine network, where machines are able to send failure directly to smart operators, as well as to call other systems for fault repair action. Again, cyber-physical system, Internet of Things, all the series of sensors and actuators that are implemented allow the implementation of the so-called Karakuri technologies, that are the technologies that aim at using natural physical phenomena, for example, gravity force, wind, and electromagnetic power, aided by elementary mechanisms such as LIVA, link, and pulley mechanism. As a result, it's possible to obtain environmental-friendly operations, workload mitigation, operation simplification, ease of maintenance, as well as low-cost automation. Again, robots can be implement such this technology in Industry 4.0 environment, incorporating robots and generally automation with human activity, for example, in an industrial assembly process, a direct interaction between robot and operator. As a result, it's possible to obtain an optimal distribution of tasks between human and machines and gaining benefits in productivity. Assembly system able to produce complex on-demand products and reduce costs, and combine the creativity, intelligence, knowledge, flexibility, and skill of humans with the electronics and physical power, having speed and accuracy of a machine. Finally, sensor actuators, cloud computing, big data analytics, and augmented reality are able to replace a conventional Kanban system by a vertical integrated solution of machine-to-machine communication. It's possible to obtain a gapless information flow. An additional benefit derived by the increasing level of traceability and process reliability, and elimination of shop floor near located stock and minimization of the warehouse space. I want to show you as a final slide the relative impact magnitude of Industry 4.0 technology on lean production implementation. As is possible to see in a visual way, cyber-physical system is the technology more impactful. That allow to enable, for example, the computer integrated manufacturing, Jitoka, Kanban, quality control. Also big data with the computer can support computer integrated manufacturing, software development, WIP production, and followed by Internet of Things, robots, augmented reality, and additive manufacturing. To sum up, in this review, we found 36 articles that match the purpose of understanding the integration of Industry 4.0 technologies with the lean production procedures. Results show how Industry 4.0 tools can be integrated with lean production, allowing the improvement of both flexibility and productivity in lean automation system. Also, several authors argue that the human factor can be considered a key aspect for such integration. Lean production and Industry 4.0 both favor the decentralization of structures over large complex machines, and both aim for small modules with low levels of complexity. As a future research, we would like to elaborate a more systematic analysis of literature, for example, through a systematic literature review, with a particular focus on available case studies that dealt with an actual implementation, highlighting main drivers and barriers. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, very much for your presentation. Very interesting.